Hey guys, this is Gilbert, and today we'll be playing Nisha Tibido in a 15-10 game. I like this time control, it gives me enough time to play. Let's go to Queen's Indian Defense, foreshadowing the bishop. Let's pin the knight. Hopefully going for some kind of Nimzo-Indian crossover. Queen to two, I'm expecting. Let's chop and castle. King safety is very important. Let's foreshadow the bishop. I think we should make a flight square. If not, maybe d5 or c5. C5 captures. Knight a6 looks interesting. D6 maybe. D6 is getting ready to play c5. Yeah, let's get this flight square and take away squares from this knight. Do I want to play a5? Nah, a5 just gives too much control of this square. I need a6. I need to be able to play that later. What about a move like d5? A move like d5, I kind of don't like that it gets in the way of my bishop. So let's play d6. Maybe we can get ready for knight d7. And he's trying to crack open the position. I'm thinking just knight to d7. Notice this pawn can get pretty advanced. Maybe even knight here. What to do? I was thinking just knight to d7, but I gotta be careful about a6. Notice that my bishop would get kicked off this diagonal. I'm thinking just a6, playing that myself. A6, pawn captures, pawn captures. Yeah, that looks better. Just gotta be careful about pins on this diagonal with the bishop. And also discovered attacks on this pawn. But I think a6 is the way to go. I don't really want the a-file to open up. Let's pre-move this capture. Notice that if the queen moves, this knight is going to get chopped if the king decides to castle. So this queen has an extra duty, protect the knight. I like that d6 is taking away this key e5 square from the knight. Could be useful. So here I was thinking just rook to e8, getting ready to play. We're just moving out of the pin. Let's do that. does my knight belong? So it looks like we got out of the opening in pretty good shape. So that's good. Now we gotta start making plans for the middle game. I'm looking at moves like e5, pawn captures, knight, bishop captures, queen captures. I see, I have this rook undefended at the end of that. So I was thinking the rook captures and he gets active and I can put him on this square and it would be good, attack the king that way. But this knight needs to move first. Maybe just knight to d7? Knight d7 drops a pawn, so no. I don't know if knight a5 is good. It could be. I'm thinking maybe rook to c8, knight to a5, those kind of moves. They seem good. I did allow his pawn to advance, but what about a move like this? Take a second. Knight to a5. I'm looking at e5, which is played by him directly. What if I play e5? I think I like e5. E5 captures, pawn captures. E5, pawn captures, knight captures. I like e5. I think it's active. Let's open up the position. Our rook is ready to play. Probably knight takes is best since it allows a rook to have a semi-open file. A semi-open file, remember, is there's only one pawn on the file instead of two. Like here, the C file is a semi-open file for me, while the C file is a semi-open file for white. I could just capture. I'm looking at either this capture or this capture. I don't necessarily want to take with this because then the rook gets very active against my bishop. I don't want that. I like that we start getting threats against the e4 pawn in this line. So I think I'll play it. This is a pretty important stage of the game. The pawn structure is changing. We gotta watch out. We don't want to get an unfavorable pawn structure where our pieces can't get into play. Gotta be really careful here. I'm thinking that he'll capture my d pawn. He does not. Can I just win the pawn? I don't necessarily want to keep the d pawn. There's no one to protect them. Let's open up. If I open up. Yeah, I think it's okay. I might get kicked around, my knights. But I do like the position I'm getting. Seems favorable. I like that my rook has some scope now. Here I could possibly just push. Play against that. Yeah, let's do that. I like my queen side. It's solid. I like that I'm blocking in this bishop. I like that my rook has scope. But notice that there's a punch being thrown at this pawn. Which is met by the defense of the queen. This strikes me as interesting. Knight d4, knight captures, queen captures, pawn to c6. I think I get rook c8 in that line at the end. If he captures, there's a pin on the queen. What if I play rook c8 first? That gives him time to protect the pawn. Notice also that my knight isn't around to defend the square anymore, so e5 is an option. So let's recalculate that. Knight to d4, knight captures, queen captures. Pawn to e5 can't be played there, my queen is there. I like the position. Let's go for it. That's a pretty move. I think it's opening up well for me. I'm not too worried about. What to do? Do I care about this opening of the king side? Maybe. Do I want to play queen d8? Possibly. I want to move where I can still defend. I guess e5 can be played now. This bishop is too strong. I want to keep pressure on this. I like my queen on d4, but it's getting kicked away. Maybe queen here? No, I think I'd get kicked around by the rooks there. Maybe just queen to d7. Queen d7, bishop captures knight, pawn captures. How badly do I care? Do I want to play queen d8? Let's play queen d8. I don't want my king side to be cracked open right now. Let's pin. Notice that he can't promote if he captures my bishop. Very important. My queen and my rook are both handling the defense of the back rank. So it's okay. I think we'll scoop up that pawn pretty soon. Let's pre-move this. If push, I just capture. So that was an oversight by my opponent. Maybe an option is a move like e5. I guess he's going for it. Let's attack the bishop and the queen and the pawn. Do I need to right away? I could also just capture. I need to calculate this. I don't want this pawn to kill me. Knight captures, bishop captures, rook captures. Rook here. I think I'm okay. My queen is a good defender. Let's pre-move that capture. I think we're doing really good here. Maybe knight to d6 in the future. Just getting ready to scoop up the pawn. What about a move like rook here? Again, just knight to d6. Well, we drop a pawn here. Very dangerous pawn to have dropped. Notice that now there's threats. Threats here. So maybe queen d5 catches my attention. Notice I could capture since I'm on the same diagonal. Let's do that. If bishop here, I capture the pawn. The only threat in this position is this pawn on b7. If I can get rid of it, it's easy conversion. So we gotta capture here. Notice that this rook might come to b6. I guess I'd just play rook to b8. Again, rook a8 doesn't work. I would just capture. Pawn captures. And look at that queen coming back to scoop up the pieces. I think it's game over for my opponent at this stage. Let's see if he can get any counterplay. I don't really see it. Yeah, here I was thinking just scoop up the pawn. He can't play anything like this. So I am winning the pawn. Notice if a move like f3 is played, there's a fork on the rook and the king. Looks like we have a just a simple conversion. We have the material, we just gotta win the game. Which could prove difficult. Two rooks and a bishop versus a queen and a rook. Let's pre-move that. Queen versus rook and a bishop. It'll be interesting. Could be drawish now that I look at it because I need to have a good way to have activity. I'm looking at moves like queen d3, taking away these two squares. From the bishop. Maybe just queen c2 is best. Queen c2, rook e8. I'm not worried about rook e8. I'm thinking queen c2. Maybe even queen to g6. Let's play this. I don't want him to defend his piece like this. We're ready to play King H7 if need be. I want this trade. It's favorable. Notice if we trade the rooks, we win the bishop. Well, actually, no. Not necessarily. Probably rook back is gonna be played. I think trading one side of trading the rooks is a pretty good thing to do here. Maybe not though. He's not gonna capture. That would just lead to me winning a piece. The good thing about this game is that I have enough time to actually win it. 5 minutes plus a good increment. It's a good amount of time. Now here the question is, do I want to capture the rook? Maybe not. I'm looking at moves like rook to b5, getting ready to go to g5, and then queen g6, making weaknesses, attacking, possibly using my pawns. Let's go for that. I don't want the rooks to get too active against me. Notice that now they're connected and they can work against me, so that's one reason I could consider capturing. I kind of want my rook to stay. Notice I might get kicked around, but here I'm thinking just queen to g. Queen g6, and we're good. Getting ready to swing my rook over. If check again, just king to h7, pretty simple. Gotta be careful about my king too. If the rooks get really active against him, it could be difficult. Especially if I'm on h7. See how I'd be behind this pawn? And so attacks on f7 could be dangerous for me. I don't think I'm in any danger yet, but it could begin to happen. How are you protecting this? Rook over. What if I protect like this? Notice the pin on the king. Yeah, the H pawn is just dropping. about to infiltrate on the H file. Let's capture. If rook to g3, I'm thinking just queen h5. Yeah, queen h5 looks good. Here I can either play queen h5 or rook to g4. Let's play queen h5. Threaten mates. Notice king h7 is a good square for my king. Nothing can fight that diagonal. The light squares are strong. So a mate threat. How will he respond? So we gotta start calculating. Rook to h1, queen to h4 after. So rook to h1, king f2, queen to h4. King to e2. Check, check, king to e2. I can always just play rook to h2 in that case. Let's do that. Notice how this king is running out of squares. There's also this queen check, but I don't think it leads so much. Let's go here. He might defend with the rook. In that case, I think I'll just double down and bring in the queen. Notice that the pawn is pinned. Here I was thinking just queen to g3 and scoop up the pawn. Queen to g3. What about king f1? What to do here? Yeah, probably just queen to g3, queen to g3, king f1, then what? King to f1. What's going on? I have these checks. Yeah, so if his king is on. If his king is on f1, what do I play? King F1. Maybe just rook H5, swinging over. Let's swing the rook over. This rook is passive now, so we at least achieve that. This rook here seems deadly. What about this? Yeah, this is just winning. Alright, rook here, check. Let's double check. Rook here, check. Queen takes, pawn takes. And then we just get the rook at the end. Let's do that. Notice that if he takes, I can take this pawn. Now it's just a rook versus a bishop. I should be able to win that. There's probably a faster way, and I'll look at that at the end of the video. Let's just get our queen active, see if we can pick up the rook. This bringing the queen in closer. Also trying to win the bishop if possible. Trying to find a fork for this rook and this king. Threatening to play h4. h4, he captures. I don't have that fork. Let's go here. Let's protect this pawn. That way our queen can go do other things. So what's going on here? I think that might be a longer conversion now. Definitely messed up somewhat. If all else fails, I'll just try to win with a passed pawn. Get the king active. Let's give a check. I'm trying to get closer. Turning to win this pawn. He has to go back. He can't go forward. gotta be careful about check. Notice that we did open this diagonal. I like the pin. If no, I don't think there'll be a pin. Let's get the king out. King out, rook down. Let's play this. If rook down, king here, if check, I always have king to g6. Very important. If I get checked again, I can always go to f5. And then now I have better control. My king is participating, my pawns are about to kick the king. That should be better for me. Running kind of low on time. Gotta make sure I don't mess this up. Let's go here. Let's go here. If check, he has to go to the square. So there's only one move. I was thinking queen here, but we gotta look at rook captures. Rook captures. Rook, king to e6. Check. Looks like he ran out of checks. So again, probably just king here. Notice we're trying to pick up the bishop. We just check. Check. King down. I think I could play a move like g4. Notice I'm not scared about this bishop. I can capture the rook in that case. Move like this is what I'm looking at. It looks like it's game over. Capture the pawn. I should have captured the queen. Missed that. Let's go here. Threatening queens. Okay. So he's out of checks, so what will he do? Very sloppy technique by me. And he resigns. Good game. Good game by my opponent. I don't really have time to make another video right now, even though he wants a rematch. So we got out of the opening pretty well. I wonder if I should have addressed this. No. So we're doing great. Notice that there's this idea. I thought, what about just captures? I guess there's always this square, right? This knight is pinned to the defense of g2. So yeah, it was at this point. I didn't really like when he played this. I thought it just made it too easy. This pawn is gonna drop. Before then, it was kind of even-ish, but then I just saw the pawns dropped. Yeah, I should have combated this pawn right away, but I didn't. Notice how he could have captured. Ah, okay. And then rook captures. So just a different change of moves. Here, I can't play queen over, I have to play rook back. Notice that there's this threat. If here, right, I missed all this. I thought I had enough defense. But I guess I was missing that the rook can take on a6. But now we're just doing well. It's just conversion at this point. Wonder what the. Yeah, the engine likes my move. But I should have captured, okay. Why is that? Blunt the bishop. Okay, now the bishop can't do anything. And then I can just start using my pawns, attack the king, etc. So that would have been good. But I don't play that. So we're doing good here. Here I wasn't sure what to do. I played this, but notice that I have more checking opportunities on this square. I like this square more. I consider this square and this square, but I completely overlooked g5. What about just king f1 in this case? Yeah, just bring it over the rook. This rook is too passive. So now we're threatening moves like check. Let's say something like, I don't know, here. This mate's coming up already. This rook is too active. So here I thought I had the capture, but I guess I didn't. Both moves are winning, of course. Notice this back rank is hard to deal with. How am I winning this? Rook is just coming in. I missed this check. If king here. Check. I wasn't sure where this is going. What about just back? Check. Back. Here, okay. And then. Okay. So now when he goes back, I can win the piece. That's really interesting. I didn't see that at all. I noticed this bishop was loose, but I didn't know how to get there. And I guess I just could have wiggled my way upward towards this bishop. That would have been an easier way. But I missed that. Well, that's all I have for you guys today. Thanks for watching. Please leave any suggestions, comments below. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.